Mic check, what's kicking, family? I'm glad you've clicked in so I can check in with you. This is Mr. Batch, and I want to kick it about Tony Parker and his $20 million lawsuit. As you know, Drake and Chris Brown had a brawl in Club W.I.P. here in New York over an alleged slight of Drake to Chris Brown. As the story goes, and they're in the club together, not together, so to speak, they were both present at a club, W.I.P., for some party. He sends him a bottle. What is it? Is it a 2,000 bottle, 5,000 bottle? 5,000 bottle of champagne. Sends it to Drake. Drake sends it back with a note, with an expletive deleted on it. And the next thing you know, all hell broke loose. Bottles was flying all over the place. Damn! Oh, excuse me. Sorry about that. Oh, wow! Ooh, that ragweed was really kicking up there. Please excuse me for sneezing on camera like that. Bad etiquette. But Mr. Batch continues. So, bottle gets sent back with a note. Next thing you know, brawl ensues. Bottles are thrown all over the place. A couple of tourists are hurt. Then the next day, it comes out that Tony Parker was in the club with some other famous notable people the night that the brawl went down. Tony Parker has some discomfort. He goes to the hospital. The next day, they find a shard of that champagne bottle in his eye, punctures the cornea. Now they're talking about they had some surgery. I guess they had to have surgery to pull it out. You just don't, you know, go in there and just hit blink. You know, so now Mr. Parker might not make the Olympic Games and play with his team, the French. You know, he's a French national. So, yo, that's jerk. That's messed up by two idiots. Two idiots. Two idiots. I'm going to say it again. Two idiots. Now, Mr. Parker is well within his rights to sue. The suit claims that the club did not provide enough protection for the patrons due to the alleged tension between Mr. Drake and Mr. Chris Brown. They were at the club with very large entourages. So most likely somebody in their entourage kicked it off by throwing a bottle. Throwing a bottle. I mean, if there's that much beef, yo, get with the knuckle game. Get with the knuckle game. Go mano y mano. You know, because come on now. Cameras catch it. See, that's the thing. Cameras. There's so many cameras today than there was 5 years ago, let alone 20, that, you know, you're going to get caught on tape. You're going to get caught on film. So, Mr. Parker, with Welwyn in his right, it's going to mess up my viewing of the Olympics because I might not be able to see Mr. Parker participate. And, you know, and that's one of the things. Summer Olympics is coming up. It's coming up in England. And I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be a nice, you know, I always look forward to the Olympics. You know, it's, I always like watching the Olympics. Like it, you know, the Summer Olympics and stuff like the Winter Olympics too. But my commentary on Drake and Chris Brown is this. You guys want to brawl inside of a club. Why don't y'all take it up someplace on the street where innocent people could not possibly get injured? Then on top of that, why don't y'all just get with the knuckle game? Now, with that being said, I had talked to some various people. You know, I'm like, you know, after the incident, I just went around making conversation, you know, and I was asking people, you know, men and women alike, my age group, said the two young men were stupid, silly. Stupid and silly. They said some other things, but I'm gonna reserve that for those people, what they want to say, and I just want to make sure I keep this clean. Then I posed the question to the age group closest, you know, to Drake and Chris Brown. And some young brothers really, you know, they hit it right on the head, and they told me this. They said, those two dudes were stupid. And I said, why? They're famous. They have the pick of any woman that they want across the planet. And I said, you know something, son? You are damn right. And then I had said, you know, something that I'm not going to repeat here. You know,
woo, risque
on what I had said. Some of you brothers my age group would probably understand what I had said about that. I'll just leave that to the imagination. But those gentlemen were right about them being famous and being able to get any female on the planet due to their fame and notoriety and stuff like that. So I blame their entourage, their crew, their posse. And then on top of that, you ain't got no control over your crew and posse. They have no respect for you, you know, for you whatsoever. They just bring that thug, that you know, mentality into a public space where people are spending money. Now, there was a bunch of notable people up inside that club from the reports that I was reading the day after the incident, a couple of days after that. There were some famous people inside the club. Now, you're going to... I don't get it. Why do you guys want to play like you thugs? You're not that tough. If you that tough, you'd go mano a mano. Drake, you ain't that tough either. Come on, man. You want to talk about you tough? The only tough people from Canada. Yes, Drake is from Canada. The only tough people from Canada are hockey players and CFLers. Those are the tough guys. Not Drake. Chris Brown? Not you either. And Chris Brown need to chill because, yo, I mean, after the Rihanna thing, I don't know if that's a violation of his probation or anything like that, but I guess he hasn't been arrested, so hey, therefore, bye. I hope Tony Parker gets his $20 million out of the W.I.P. club. I don't know what the cops are going to do about the situation between Drake and Chris Brown. There should be some charges against them two gentlemen, just like how they had against Pac-Man Jones when he made it rain inside that club. I think the authorities should go after Drake and Chris Brown for that incident in the club. Now, the club was supposed to have been shut down. It was shut down for a few days. I haven't read anything in the paper about it being opened back up. But here in New York, it's very hard to shut down clubs like that because I was reading a report in the papers talking about they have politicians in their corner and all this other kind of stuff. And hey, it's a hard road to hoe. So if that's the case, then WIP, pay up. Tony Parker, get well. Hopefully you can be well enough that you can play with the French Nationals in the Olympics. And Drake and Chris Brown, man up. Get with the knuckle game, mano a mano. Throwing bombs. Bitch assness. This is Mr. Batch. I'm out of here like I stole something. Peace!